I remember, oh, I don't know, a week or so ago, Plan B had been watching one of my streams and commented to how the wheel looked like I was driving an 18-wheeler, basically. So I decided I'd try a different angle tonight and see if that puts things into perspective a little bit better. So I'm moving the camera and we'll see how it goes. Excuse me. We're at league night tonight. And it's gonna suck. At least for Cruz and I suspect. We are at Hungaro Ring and it is raining. Our goal in this race, when we set this one up, because we've only done a few rain races throughout the season, and I don't know that we'll do a lot more of them because they're just not as much fun, to be honest with you. Our goal in this one, we've kind of steadily increase the difficulty of the rain races. Our first one we did at Silverstone early in the season, and it was a disaster. We had too much rain, and nobody could keep the car on the track. So then we decided to just sort of build towards a more legitimate rain race, and we raced, I think, at Catalunya first, but really just kind of damp conditions, at best damp conditions. We're definitely using dry tires and dry setups for that race, and then we did Kyalami with just a little bit more, still a dry setup, but definitely a bit more slick where you could screw yourself up if you weren't careful. And then, careful, man. Where are you? You can smell it, can't you? I have a treat for him to keep him busy, but I wanted to wait until qualifying started. I don't know if I'm going to be able to because he is looking everywhere for it. All right, man. Go get it. Yeah, I knew it. You dumbass. Right back. Idiot. Me and my moron. Anyway, so back to what I was saying. So we were in this race, we were going for a legitimate wet race that would be challenging. You'd have to run wets for the entire race, but without making it so difficult that you don't have any grip at all, you know. So I think we've got that pretty well done as far as conditions go. So there's still plenty of water out there to spin you if you're not careful and if you're making mistakes. The Lambo has really struggled in it. There's no question. This track in these conditions, it has not been good at all. Cruz and I have been struggling with it all week. I went with a very safe setup to make it as stable as I can, and really just spent the entire week trying to get through an entire hour of doing laps on this track without spinning or putting myself into a wall. I was finally able to accomplish that yesterday, and so I don't expect to be anywhere near the leader's pace, but if I can keep it clean, keep it on the track, and just see where everyone else shakes out, I know the Bentleys are going to be pretty OP, no question about that. I haven't seen Cope run any laps yet, but I would assume that Lexus should be pretty solid in these conditions as well. The curbs are just disasters here for the Lamborghini, and I think a lot of the mid-engine cars in general. And Millie looks like he's putting up some very solid times in his Ferrari, and I think that's pretty impressive. But for the most part, those of us in mid-engine or like Ratman in the rear engine, we're not really touching the Bentley's times. So if they run clean races at that kind of pace, they're going to run away with it pretty much, and the rest of us will just be also-rans more than anything else. But that's where we're at, and we'll see how it goes. Let me think. Since next weekend is 4th of July weekend, we won't be running a league race. We're going to wind up doing an invitational both on Friday and Sunday night. And then next league race is 2 weeks away at Bathurst, which is going to be fun, but also difficult because we've made it a full endurance race, 2 full hours at Bathurst. And that is, I mean, that's just hard. You know, there's no such thing as a small wreck up on the mountain, so you've got to keep it clean up there for 2 full hours. And for, let's face it, amateurs like us, that's pretty tough to do. Same thing in a race like this. It's one thing to run fast laps, it's another thing to do it consistently. And one of the things that I marvel at when I watch, like, Jardier or who Nils Najax, those guys who are the really, really good sim racers. Their consistency both on dry tracks and wet tracks, their ability to go turn fast laps over and over again on a wet track is incredibly impressive to me. And by and large, that's not something that we, as just your run-of-the-mill amateur sim racers, can pull off. So, big question tonight will be who can keep a clean race. There's no question about that. Even the fast guys, if they're not able to stay on the track while they maintain that pace, they could wind up running right back into somebody's lap in a heartbeat. So we'll see how it goes. But the same thing with Bathurst, you know, it's one thing to run a fast lap, it's a completely different thing to run for 2 hours on Bathurst without making any significant mistakes, particularly up there on the top of the mountain. All your speed can count for naught. I know for a fact that Cruz is baked out of his gourd right now. He promised he would be, and he delivered. His theory being, you know what? Screw it. Relax. Turn some music on, and just run laps and see where you wind up. I think that is a brilliant strategy by my teammate, and it makes me wish that I smoked a little bit myself because it would be good for tonight. How much longer do we have until qualifying? I know we've got to be close. Another 2 minutes, basically. There is no stop required in this race, and I know Cruz and I are planning to do it as a no-stop race with the wet tires. You know, you're not really putting enough damage on them to in these conditions to even need to change tires, so that's not necessary. So just, you know, take the gas that you need, go one set of tires, and 1 hour is no problem. I'll be surprised if anybody does pit. I can't imagine that anyone would really find it necessary to do that in this race. But time to go turn a fast, relatively speaking, lap. Based on how much we've struggled in these conditions this week, Cruz and I both agreed if we can finish top five, frankly, that would be a blessing.
Slow car up ahead. Yellow flag ahead. Watch out in front.
Thank you. I didn't put enough gas in the tank. It's too bad. I was working on being a decent lap. Yeah, even Coped couldn't get within damn near a second of dipping. And 7/10 behind Blast. Those Bentleys are just really strong.
Nice rain in this session, so watch out for slippery curves and remember to brake earlier.
Thank you.
30 seconds.
Blast
Stay
dipping,
easy, my
good
friend.
luck. I'm only kind of joking when I say that this is basically the speed I'd like to be able to go for the next hour. But I know I can't do that.
Double five.
Echo, if you pull my camera down again, I'm gonna beat the hell out of you. Go away. Go away. Hey. Get out of there. Echo. Don't kill your teammate. Don't kill your teammate. Don't kill your teammate.
Car on the left. Clear on the left.
Don't kill Ratman. Don't kill Ratman. Don't kill Ratman. Okay, Sparky, that was a bad lap. Let's focus. Ratman's running some very good times behind me. He can keep from making mistakes. He's going to catch me eventually. For myself, I don't mind him getting by because I don't need the distraction. But I'd kind of like to have kept him off a cruise. Purple park it. Looks like it. Swift, sorry about that, bud. The Lambo is so nervous on this track that it takes an enormous amount of my attention to keep it on the black stuff. And it just punishes any mistakes, which means when I've got somebody climbing up my ass, that's just a lot to ask.
Yellow flag, be careful there. There's a slow car ahead.
Looks like Millie made a mistake. Cruz got by. And Millie must have picked up some damage. He's really slowed down quite a bit. Okay, one lap to keep Swift behind me. Need to get through sector two. Nice racing, boys. Nice and clean. Well done. Whew. Well, I'm glad that's done. Nice job, Cruz. Hanging in there for fourth. Held off a rat man. Seriously, I can live with sixth. That doesn't bother me in the slightest. Just the one real mistake there in front of Swift, but otherwise pretty solid, or you know, under the circumstances. Well, I got to watch Dippin or Cope's replay because it looks like they were fighting it out pretty much the whole time. And I'm very curious to see that. So nice job there, boys. Not surprised with both the Bentleys and the Lexus up front and by a wide margin. Nothing shocking about that at all. So anyway, I'm glad that's done, to be perfectly honest. There isn't anything pleasant about driving the Lambo on this track in the rain. So yeah, overall, can't complain too much. Thanks for watching this, guys. We'll see you next week. I think we're, let's see, Friday night. I don't think we know what we're doing yet. But then on Sunday, on 4th of July, we're gonna just do an invitational in lieu of the league race. And we're going to run Laguna Seca with the Chevy. So everybody's in the Chevy. GT4 at Laguna Seca, very American. And yeah, so that should be fun. I love driving the Chevy. I think it's a blast, and Laguna is one of my favorite tracks, so that should be a good time. Thanks for watching, and see you next time. Have a good night though.